Once more onto the Shep, I guess. Hey, what's up? Ta-da! It's back to the blooper. Hey, there goes my wife somewhere. To a different part of the house. What the heck is a dwelling?
Welcome to Alliance Military Database.
Aw, thanks for that. I
Classified
appreciate the
information
welcome.
requested. Establishing secure connection. Secure connection confirmed.
In the bedroom with you? Oh, yeah, let's bring him in. No, the big babies can come in. You want to bring him in? Oh, I could, there is a new game plus. That's cool. That's cool.
Welcome to Alliance Military Database. Classified information requested.
Do you want me to get the boy?
Establishing secure connection. Secure
Our big
connection
kitty's so slow.
Confirmed. Please log in to access your profile.
Did the kitten get a treat too? Oh. No, it's just really cute and funny that he's getting carried all around. That's good, no. Is that Aqua? Or Navy? It looks cute. You gonna take a nap or watch some TV in there? Oh, yeah, I don't care if you fall asleep with the TV on. I love. Go relax. My wife is sick. She's sick.
Warning, data corruption detected. Please reconstruct profile. Confirm pre-service history. Please log in to access your profile.
Oh, there we go. I pressed A because I was trying to change the name, and then it started going to the next step, and then I touched the keyboard to change it. Let's see. Let's look at some baby names. I'm trying to find some Mass Effect stuff that I have saved, but I have so much Alien stuff saved in between, which is really funny. Recently, after watching Romulus, Vice, actually, we watched... Leading up to it, we already watched the Alien quadrilogy. Ugh, I hate that word. The first time I saw it was in relation to that on those VHSs and DVDs. VHSs are big hunks of rectangular three-dimensional plastic, and they house magnetic tape inside of it, and those produce images. Anyway, after watching Romulus a couple of times, we ended up watching Prometheus, which my wife hadn't seen since it had come out, and Alien Covenant, which she had never seen previously. And both of them were enjoyable, but, you know, not without their flaws or faults. They were weird. They had their own weird, weird things going on. Yeah, let's go with a little mix and match. Let's do a little Nintendo BioWare PC kind of deal. I'm the Sage of the Forest. I'm the Sage of the Forest.
Data corruption detected.
Bitch.
Please reconstruct profile. Confirm pre-service history.
Both of your parents were in the Alliance military. Your childhood was spent on ships and stations as they transferred from posting to posting, never staying in one location for more than a few years. Following in your parents' footsteps, you enlisted at the age of 18. You were born and raised on Mindwar, a small border colony in the Attican Traverse. When you were 16, slavers raided Mindwar, slaughtering your family. You can't spell slaughter without laughter. And friends, you were saved by a passing Alliance patrol and you enlisted with the military a few years later. Earthborn, you were an orphan raised on the streets of the great megatropolises covering Earth. You escaped the life of petty crime and underworld gangs by enlisting with the Alliance military when you turned 18. I haven't done Spacer, actually. Let's do Spacer for the first time. I've done Soul Survivor before. I've never done Ruthless or... I've done War Hero also. I'm gonna make some Renegade choices. I'm not gonna do them all, but I'm gonna do some. I'm tempted to save Ruthless. Like, I have zero Ruths. None. War Hero. Earlier in your military career, you found yourself facing an overwhelming enemy force. You risked your own life to save your fellow soldiers and defeat the enemy. Despite the impossible odds, your bravery and heroism have earned you medals and recognition from the Alliance fleet. Mein Gott. It doesn't matter too much. I just know that it's a couple little dialogue things throughout the trilogy, and it might be fun to see. For me. No, let's be a dickhead. Ruthless.
Military specialization.
I usually play an engineer in the old games. I think I played Sentinel my first time through this and it was fine. light armor and no specialized. Shotguns kind of sucks, but I mean, medium armor seems like it might be a little better. Let's see. Biotics are going to be super helpful. Let's do this. Let's do Vanguard for my insanity run. So I like the bonus talent. I get a bonus talent? Why? I don't know what I did to deserve this, but yes, I would like this. Wow. Both seem really good. I've never really played Mass Effect 1 with sniper rifles, and it's tempting to. Let's do it. Oh man, but assault rifle feels like it's going to make the game way easier. Let's do assault rifle. I'm going to cheese it. Confirm. Sorry. Facial identification. Sorry, game. Sorry. Hey, kitty cat. Come on. Come on. Come on up, boy. Okay. Oh. Oh my god, my cat just drooled all over me. Dude, why? Why would you do that? You get a little bit of attention, and you become a drooler. My boy. My boy. My boy cat. That purple is too purple.
They're never gonna stop!
Endless trap!
Hey, thank you, thank you. What is up with you? Hope you're doing well. Thanks for that follow. Hair. Makeup. Scar. Aw, oh, really, man? That's cool. Yeah, they're such dorks. They seem chill. I like that. They're just like weird recluses. I don't know. I'm from Chicago in the Midwest and grew up with a lot of the stuff they talk about, like Svengoolie and Bozo the Clown. And it's cool. Because they're just up in Wisconsin there. They talk about going down to Chicago for events and yeah. It just reminds me of all my fat, cheese-fried, grown friends back in the north. Hair. No! Okay, I don't know. Red's too cliche. I can't just do red femshep again. I'm sick of it. The purples look too gross, like phony to me. I don't like it. I really wish there was a color wheel. I don't know why there's not, maybe for the lighting. Oh, that red looks nice. I could nut for that. I like the silver, but I don't want to be old Shep. I wish it looked more silver than gray. Black's not going to show up well in the lighting. I think I'm going to go with a blondish Shep. I think she's got to be it. Oh, yeah. Macaulay Culkin showing up. Patton Oswalt showing up in at least one thing. Weird crossovers. Alright. Finalize.
Profile reconstruction complete.
Once you confirm your character, yes, I know.
Identification confirmed.
Let's go to insanity because pain. Legendary mode scaling, squad power usage, subtitles, autosave, enable toots. Yeah, give me that good toot.
Well, what about Shepard?
And Patton is it within his right, and he shouldn't go back. They'll just make him suffer more.
Military service runs in the family.
Patton Oswalt lost his wife. He doesn't need any more stress on his heart.
She gets the job done, no matter what the cost.
Is that the kind of person we want protecting the galaxy?
Maybe.
That's the only kind of person who can protect the galaxy.
I'll make the call.
In the year 2148, explorers on Mars discover the remains of an ancient spacefaring civilization. In the decades that follow, these mysterious artifacts reveal startling new technologies, enabling travel to the furthest stars. The basis for this incredible technology was a force that controlled the very fabric of space and time. They called it the greatest discovery in human history, Mass Effect. Bum bum bum. Ass Effect. Oh, look at that big old Jupiter ice storm.
The Arcturus Prime relay is in range. Initiating transmission sequence.
Commander?
Oh, yeah. Counselor Odina, he's a real. See you next Tuesday.
We are connected.
Fucking out of my way, Presley. And slap him. Screenshot. Ah, fuck, I missed it.
The board is green. Approach run has begun. Hitting the relay in 3, 2.
Just fly into the space gun.
Thrusters.
Let's get rail gunned across the galaxy.
Check. Internal emissions. Kapow. All systems online. Drift.
Nah, fuck Udina. He has a shootable face. Pop him every chance I get.
Your captain will be pleased.
Let him just eat lead in 3.
I hate that guy.
Nihilus gave you a compliment. So you hate him.
Eat space lead.
You remember
shaved
to
off
up your jumpsuit on the way out of the bathroom? That's good. I just jumped us halfway across the galaxy and hit a target the size of a pinhead. So that's incredible. Besides, specters are trouble. I don't like having them on board. Call me paranoid.
You're paranoid. The council helped fund this project. They have a right to send someone to keep an eye on their investment.
Yeah, that is the official story. But only an idiot believes the official story.
Seth Green gave me a free ice cream pop at San Diego Comic-Con in 2011 out of an Adult Swim truck. He and one of the other guys from Robot Chicken were in an Adult Swim ice cream truck, and there was a huge line, and they were just giving out free ice cream to everyone one at a time as they were coming up. It was orderly. It wasn't like a mob or anything.
Just cleared the mass relay, Captain. Stealth systems engaged.
But we were one of the last few people to grab a free treat from our ginger friend here.
Aye, aye, Captain. Better brace yourself, sir. I think Nihilus is headed your way.
He's already here, Lieutenant.
He's right behind me, isn't he?
You get that, Commander?
He sounds angry. Something must have gone wrong with the mission.
You won't like him when he's angry.
Captain always sounds like that when he's talking to me.
Can't possibly imagine why.
I'm telling you, I just saw him. He marched by like he was on a mission.
He's a Spectre. They're always on a mission.
And we're getting dragged, right along with him.
Relax, Presley. You're gonna give yourself an ulcer.
Ooh, that's really cool. No, I only ever got to go that once.
Congratulations,
very
Commander.
That's cool. Looks like pretty bomb. They had all that stuff in Hall H.
Very cool.
I heard you arguing. Yeah.
Sounds like
you were being a space racist.
Very cool.
Very cool. Very cool. Very cool. Very cool. Very cool.
Very cool.
Whole crew feels very cool.
Very cool.
Do you think the Alliance brass is holding out on us?
It's so loud.
Is test out the stealth system. Why is Captain Anderson in charge? And then there's Nihilus. Spectres are elite operatives, top covert agents. Why send a Spectre, a Turian Spectre, on a shakedown run? It doesn't add up.
What do you know about the stealth systems?
I just know it masks our location from scans and sensors. Cutting-edge technology. The Normandy's the only ship with this prototype drive. But why are we fully staffed? A skeleton crew would be cheaper. Less
technically
chance
in a movie.
Plus there's Nihilus. It's pretty
the pest kind of nickly. A cover.
For what?
Damned if I know, Commander. We're out here on false pretenses. I'm not a fan of being left in the dark.
Undercover goth girl, how do you like my new Shep?
Do you have a problem with the captain?
No, ma'am. But I can't figure out what he's doing here. Captain Anderson is one of the most decorated special forces officers in the service.
He's so decorated. He's glamorous even.
He could make a life-size statue of himself. You don't send a soldier like that on a do-nothing mission.
Makeup? What are you talking about? This is natural.
Something big is going on.
Is this not a completely natural human lip color to you? Maybe my shepherd drowned. I don't know.
You don't trust Nihilus.
I don't like Turians in general. It runs in my family. My grandfather fought in the First Contact War, lost a lot of friends when the Turians hit us.
Wow, so you're like, fuck them Turians, huh? Okay. That was long ago, man.
That was 30 years ago. You can't blame Nihilus for that.
You have to let it go, Presley.
But it still makes me nervous to have a Spectre on board, especially a Turian. We're an Alliance vessel, human military, but Nihilus doesn't answer to the captain like the rest of us. Spectres operate outside the normal chain of command, and they don't come along just to observe shakedown runs. Nihilus looks like he's expecting some heavy action. I don't like it.
Nihilus has no rules. He gets full bathroom privileges, full kitchen privileges. He gets the best parking space. Just do your damn job.
I'll see if I can get some answers when I see him.
Good luck, Commander.
Natural eyeshadow, natty lips, very demure, very natural, yeah. She's pretty beefy too and all natty, no steroids. Oh wow, that archivist achievement is very easily missable. In my very first convo with Anderson here, it could be zip gone. And this is like a 20 to 40 hour game, depending on how much completionist you want to do. If you want to like fly to every planet, do all those little side quests, pick up all the dog tags or whatever, pick up all the artifacts, then it could be a much longer game. And you could miss it in like the first 10, 15 minutes and then it's gone. That's so frustrating. That's so funny.
What do you think, Commander?
We won't be What's up, Jenkins?
Time too long, will we? I'm itching for some real
Kitten
action.
Navy is grabbing and hugging my hand, kitten. Typing go, aww. Kitten Navy is being ends with me patching up a little attention boy. Relax, Jenkins.
You need to calm down, Corporal. A good soldier stays cool even under fire.
Sorry, Commander, but this waiting's killing me. I've never been on a mission like this before, not one with a Spectre on board.
What can you tell me about Nihilus?
Turians are generally well respected by the other species. Their fleet has more patrols protecting Citadel space than any other. They don't Why? Always get on well with us, though. Some people find them too rigid. Others still blame them for the first contact.
Too bird and avian-like.
I haven't said more than two words to him. He usually only speaks to the captain.
I heard Nihilus once
took Because the two words Chalk was said were fuck you, himself. So of course Nihilus doesn't like her.
I can't believe I'm on a mission with an actual Spectre.
What do you know about the Spectres?
Only what I've heard. Spectre agents work directly for the Citadel Council. They usually work alone or in small groups. Spectres don't have any official power, though. Basically, they're a shadow organization with a mandate to preserve and protect galactic stability.
Protect it at any cost. Don't forget that part. Spectres operate above the law.
Why don't we have any of our own people in there?
Spectres usually come from the council races.
Hey, Commander, what you did on Torfin, that's what they're looking for. Success at any cost, ruthless efficiency, show no mercy. The Spectres.
The Corporal's confusing.
Wait, I gotta get back to the monster one. There we go.
No,
it's all just wild speculation.
Jenkins, I'm really sorry, but I can't really get invested in you.
Goodbye, Commander.
I don't wanna, you know, it might be a time paradox.
Yes, Commander, is there something you need?
The captain's
goodbye, Commander.
But I just know I can't get attached to you, Jenkins, that's all.
Commander Shepard, I was hoping you'd get here first. It will give us a chance to talk.
What about?
I'm interested in this world we're going to, Eden Prime. I've heard it's quite beautiful.
They say it's a paradise.
Yes, a paradise. Serene, tranquil, safe. Eden Prime has become something of a symbol for your people, hasn't it? Proof that humanity can not only establish colonies across the galaxy, but also protect them. But how safe is it, really?
Do you know something?
Your people are still newcomers, Shepard. The galaxy can be a very dangerous place. Is the Alliance truly ready for this?
I think it's about time we told the Commander what's really going on.
This mission is far more than a simple shakedown run.
Oh wow, that's really sharp.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice. 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 Nice.
That's a pretty big difference. Here's what the default game looks like. This is Mass Effect Legendary Edition, HD, and then here it is with the reshade now. And now here it is without, and then with. I knew it.
I figured there was something you weren't telling us.
We're making a covert pickup on
you. I'm glad that you are pro Mashep. Because I'm stuck with her for three games now. Whoops. Oh, wow, okay.
There must be a reason you didn't tell me about this, sir.
This comes down from the top, Commander. Information strictly on a need-to-know basis. A research team on Eden Prime unearthed some kind of beacon during an excavation. It was Prothean.
I thought the Protheans vanished 50,000 years ago.
Their legacy still remains. The mass relays, the Citadel, our ship drives. It's all based on Prothean technology.
This is Big Shepard.
Years and years of Prothean porn etchings in cave walls.
It took technology forward 200 years. But Eden Prime doesn't have the facilities to handle something like this.
Nope.
We need to bring the beacon back to the Citadel for proper study.
Obviously, this goes beyond mere human interests, Commander. This discovery could affect every species in Council space.
Why did we tell the Council?
Why didn't we keep the beacon for ourselves?
You humans don't have the best reputation. Some species see you as selfish, too unpredictable, too independent, even dangerous.
No.
Sharing that beacon will improve relations with the Council. Plus, we need their scientific expertise.
I don't want to share my beacon or my eggs. Than we do.
The beacon's not the only reason I'm here, Shepard.
Nihlus wants to see you in action, Commander. He's here to evaluate you.
Guess that explains why I bump into him every time I turn around.
The Alliance has been pushing for this for a long time. Humanity wants a larger role in shaping interstellar policy. We want more say with the Citadel Council. The Spectres represent the Council's power and authority. If they accept a human into their ranks, it shows how far the Alliance has come.
I was impressed when I studied the reports from Torfin. A grim business, but you got the job done. That's why I put your name forward as a candidate for the Spectres.
You put my name forward, not backward, not sideways, or twirling toward freedom? You support this, Captain. You put my name forward.
Why would a Turian want a human in the Spectres?
Not all Turians resent humanity. Some of us see the potential of your species. We see what you have to offer to the rest of the galaxy, and to the Spectres. We are an elite group. It's rare to find an individual with the skills we seek. I don't care that you're human, Shepard. I only
care
you do. That you can do the job.
I assume this is good for the Alliance.
Earth needs this, Shepard. We're counting on you.
I need to see your skills for myself, Commander. Eden Prime will be the first of several missions together.
You'll be in charge of the ground team. Secure the beacon and get it onto the ship ASAP. Nihlus will accompany you to observe the mission.
What do you know about the Protheans?
Just what they taught us in school. They were a technologically advanced species that ruled the galaxy 50,000 years ago. Then they vanished. Nobody really knows how or why, though I've heard plenty of theories. But everyone agrees. Galactic civilization wouldn't exist without them.
Their citadel is the very heart of galactic society, and without their mass relays, interstellar travel would be impossible. We all owe the Protheans a great debt.
Oh my god.
I'd like to know more about Eden Prime before we touch down.
It's a peaceful farming world, but it represents something much bigger. Eden Prime is one of our oldest and most successful colonies. It proved we were ready to face the challenges of settling new worlds, to forge a place for humanity beyond Earth. It symbolizes humanity's growth and evolution as a spacefaring species. And after this, it will be known as the world where humans made a discovery of galactic importance.
Why is this beacon so important?
All advanced galactic civilization is based on Prothean technology, even yours.
If we hadn't discovered those Prothean ruins buried on Mars, we'd still be stuck on Earth. That was just a small data cache. Who knows what we can learn from this beacon? What if it's a weapons archive? We can't let it fall into the wrong hands.
Like who?
The Attican Traverse isn't the most stable sector of Citadel space. There are plenty of raiders and criminal groups active in the region. They might figure a Prothean beacon is worth the risk of attacking an Alliance ship. Plus, Eden Prime is right on the border of the Terminus systems.
The Attican Traverse is under
the Terminus systems.
If the Terminus systems attack, Metal it's Gear. Not the war.
Technically, yes. But some of the species in the Terminus might be willing to start a war.
Your eyes are so green.
The last thing the Council wants is to get dragged into a major conflict with the Terminus systems. We have to keep this low-key.
Why is this beacon so...
All advanced galactic if we had...
Okay, I asked you that one already. I did not realize.
Captain, we got a...
What's wrong, Joker?
Transmission from Eden
Prime,
sir.
Crazy shit's happening on the camera. Captain, look at the camera. Whoops.
Get down!
I wonder who that is.
We are under
probably not important.
Heavy casualties. I repeat, heavy casualties. We can't get evac. They came out of nowhere. We need.
Everything cuts out after that. No comm traffic at all. Just goes dead. There's nothing.
Reverse and hold at 38.5.
Enhance, enhance.
Status report.
Looks like a giant hand.
17 minutes out, Captain. No other Alliance ships in the area.
Take us in, Joker. Fast and quiet. This mission just got a lot more complicated.
Fast and quiet. Take us in there, slow and loud. Like hippopotamuses making love.
Grab your gear and meet us in the cargo hold.
Yeah, let's go, man. Let's go down to the hold. I'm concerned about that giant hand, Commander. Admiral Anderson, whatever. Yeah, man.
Somebody was doing some serious digging here, Captain.
What a beautiful planet to frack.
Your team's
frack.
The muscle in this operation, Commander. Go in heavy and head straight for the dig site.
What about survivors, Captain?
No.
Helping survivors is a secondary objective. The beacon's your top priority.
Approaching drop point one.
Nihilus, you coming with us?
I move faster on my own.
Nihilus will scout out ahead. He'll feed you status reports throughout the mission. Otherwise, I want radio silence.
We've got his back, Captain.
The mission's yours now, Shepard. Good luck.
We are approaching drop point two.
Now tuck and roll, because I don't want to stop.
Ship perimeter secure, Commander.
What the hell are those?
Let me save, because I feel like I'm gonna get freaking murdered here. I am playing on Insanity, the hardest difficulty. Let me double check I am on Insanity, because I can't start it after this mission or it doesn't count. I am. I don't know why I'm trying this. I don't think it's a good idea. It's gonna be really difficult, I feel. Oh my god. Alright, everyone be careful. Stay back. Can I level up anybody? I can. Yes. We already start with a couple of points. Let's do some pistols. And let's do one assault rifle. That's going to be very helpful. Kaden Alenko. Let's do your throw. Disrupting people is going to be really useful. We're going to need... I really want barrier so you stay alive. But first aid, because you need to keep all of us alive. Jenkins, I think I should put a lot of effort into leveling you up. It seems very important that you have a perfect thing. Like, overkill, you need that. Oh, you should definitely have combat armor. You'll need that to stay alive. Combat armor at level 2? Nothing will kill you through combat armor at level 2. Like, it's just... it's known. Oh. Oh, yeah. Thank you. I do. Praise be to the Lord above, our Lord and Savior, Reapers. May they come and harvest us every 50,000 years. Jenkins, you okay? Here, I'm gonna close your eyes with my fingers so you can nap, okay?
We'll see that he receives a proper service once the mission is complete. But I need you to stay focused.
Aye, aye, ma'am. Smells like smoke and death. Eden Prime will never be the same again.
Did I already get more levels? Oh my goodness. Yes, I did. Look at that. Oh my goodness. Increased weapon damage and melee damage. Throw is going to be good eventually. Assault rifles is good too. I'll try to get my charm up. Well, that almost felt like a waste. Can I undo that actually? Yeah. Let's do one single charm for now. There you go. Look, you get a barrier. And you can have a better... What does decryption do again? Does it allow me to hack stuff? Omni-gel recovered. I can open secure objects. Grants sabotage. Okay, thanks, Beastie Boys. With such sound enemy weapons within a certain radius. Okay, well, you already have that, my guy. Let's see. Let's just see if I can get throw and biotics to be a little OP here. Okay. It's just us now, Caden. That other guy is dead. Whatever his name was. I've already forgotten. I hope you remembered because I'm not going up there to do the eulogy without knowing it. It's going to be really... I'm the commander is all. And I should know stuff like that. Attack. Left and right. Move to a point. Regroup. Okay, well... Oh, there, now it's happened. It wasn't doing it before. Oh, okay, he was on the... No, you're looking the wrong way. Alright, I'm gonna have to peek out. But I want to peek out, but I'll peek out. Active to top, please. Let me see what this does in a scene like this. I don't know how to do all that. That's very nice, but... GG Ashley. Weird camera shot of her coming up right now. This. I do not like that weird fisheye of her. It was odd. Whoa. Don't start me in the open. What are you doing, game? What are you doing?
Thanks for your help, Commander. I didn't think I was gonna make it. Gunnery Chief Ashley Williams of the 212. You the one in charge here, ma'am?
Oh yeah, let's see what that lighting thing looks like here. I'm just gonna leave it on. No one can tell me not to, okay?
Are you wounded, Williams? A few scrapes and burns. Nothing serious. The others weren't so lucky. Oh, man. We were patrolling the perimeter when the attack hit. We tried to get off a distress call, but they cut off our communications. I've been fighting for my life ever since.
Where's the rest of your squad?
We tried to double back to the beacon, but we walked into an ambush. I don't think
any
of the
others...
Oh,
what kind of bush?
I think I'm the only one left.
This isn't your fault, Williams. You couldn't have done anything to save them.
Yes, ma'am. We held our position as long as we could, until the Geth overwhelmed us.
The Geth haven't been seen outside the Vale in nearly 200 years. Why are they here now?
They must have come for the beacon. The dig site is close, just over that rise. It might still be there.
Join us, take us there, stay here. I'll just leave Ashley on this backwater planet here now that it's been destroyed by the Geth. Peace, Williams. Nah, no, come with us.
We could use your help, Williams.
That'd be
aye,
evil.
Aye, ma'am. It's time for payback.
What else do you know about the Geth?
Just what I remember from history class back in school. They're synthetics, non-organic life forms with limited AI programming, created by the Quarians a few centuries ago. They were supposed to be a source of cheap labor, but ended up turning on the Quarians and drove them into exile. Well, after that, they just kind of disappeared behind the Perseus Veil. Nobody's really heard much from them since.
Tell me everything.
And now they're
you know
peeking
about
out from behind the veil.
They're doing some digging out here to extend
they're
the
piercing it, as one might
colony.
Say.
A few weeks ago, they unearthed some Prothean ruins and the beacon. Suddenly, every scientific expert in the colony was interested. That's when they brought us in to secure the site. I don't know much about the beacon itself, but I heard one of the researchers say this could be the biggest scientific discovery of the century.
What happened to the researchers at the dig site?
They're probably very dead.
They set up camp near the beacon. The 232 was with them. Maybe their unit fared better than mine.
I already inquired about the Geth, the beacon, prior to the attack.
Describe what happened
leading up to the attack. We were sent out a couple of nights ago from the main colony to secure the area. Seemed like a routine patrol. Until the Geth hit us. We never knew they were coming.
Have you seen a Turian Spectre around here?
There aren't any Turians on Eden Prime. None that I've ever
named by Nihilus looks like a Turian.
Be able to tell if one was a Spectre anyway.
If you saw this guy, you'd know. Carries enough firepower to wipe out a whole platoon. Luckily, he's on our side.
Sorry. Like I said, no Turians.
Move out!
The beacon's at the far end of this trench.
Oh, I was like, I can't hide because the gun isn't out. Makes sense. Are they waiting for me here? Oh, do they want me to move to that one? Let's go. Let's go. Yeah. No, no, no. Stay down. Oh, no. Oh, no. I was going to do this real quick. I was going to level Ashley. My bad. Which one gets her to heavy armor? There we go. Let's start working you there. Along with soldier, that's going to be really helpful in a little bit. Alright, I'm going to move up. If you guys have him locked down. Whap. No, not that whap. Oh my god. How embarrassing. But also, yes, that one. With the Geth. I'm not going to be able to melee this guy. Is this a joke? This is how I die. Nope, nope, nope. Yeah, move up there and get him, guys. Both of you. No, Caden, shoot him. Caden, shoot him. Get him, my guy. Yeah. Yeah, see? Teamwork. Teamwork. I hide and you kill the dude.
This is the dig site. The beacon was right here. It must have been moved.
By who? Our side or the Geth?
Hard to say. Maybe we'll know more after we check out the research camp.
You think anyone got out of here alive?
If they were lucky. Maybe hiding in the camp. It's just on the top of this ridge, up the ramps.
That man was still...
Change of plans, Shepard. There's a small spaceport up ahead.
Smells like smoke and death.
Adrenaline burst is going to be actually useful more frequently and more easily quickly, so let's just do that. Unlock electronics, unlock barrier, burp, 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 burp. Wait, which one does which here? Let's see. Difference between decryption and electronics, Mass Effect 1. Oh my god. It doesn't matter. Yeah, give us first aid, man.
Looks like they hit the camp hard.
It's a good place for an ambush. Keep your guard up. Oh god, they're still alive.
What did the Geth do to them?
Yeah, throw that husk. Not me, you fool. I mean, it still kinda is without the human parts. Sorry, I really like playing with these. Oh, that's terrible for this. That's really funny.
That door. Closed. Security locks engaged.
Why? No, no, no. That's funny. I was not expecting that at all.
Somebody's gonna pay for this.
Who? Oh, it's this one. Okay, yes.
Humans, thank the Maker.
Hurry, close the door before they come back.
Don't worry. We'll protect you.
Thank you. I think we'll be okay now. It looks like everyone's gone.
You're Dr. Warren, the one in charge of the excavation. Do you know what happened to the beacon?
It was moved to the spaceport this morning. Manuel and I stayed behind to help pack up the camp. When the attack came, the Marines held them off long enough for us to hide. They gave their lives to save us.
No one is saved! The age of humanity is ended.
So I love all these weird honeycomb design outfits on all these people. It's so vaguely futuristic.
What else can you tell me about the attack?
It all happened so fast.
And now I feel like a lot of clothing now is trying to do that. Sports clothing, just all sorts of stuff, and it looks sleek and all that, but we're not ready as a species. We're dressing ahead of our technology is all. When we're seamlessly taking a space elevator up to the moon, we could wear clothes like this, okay? I'm just saying, simmer down, guys. Just saying. Just Super Saiyan.
He was here before the attack.
That's impossible. Nihlus was with us in the Normandy before the attack. He couldn't have been here.
I'm sorry. Manuel's still a bit unsettled. We haven't seen your Turian. We've been hiding in here since the attack.
Can you tell me anything about the beacon?
It's some type of data module from a galaxy-wide communications network. Remarkably well-preserved. It could be the greatest scientific discovery of our lifetime. Miraculous new technologies, groundbreaking medical advances. Who knows what secrets are locked inside?
We have unearthed the heart.
Manuel, please. This isn't the time.
What's wrong with your assistant?
Manuel has a...
Is it madness?
I gave him an extra dose of his meds after the attack.
I can shut him up. That's funny. Why would I do that?
Williams, take us to the spaceport.
You can't stop it. Nobody can stop it. Night is falling. The darkness of eternity.
Hush, Manuel. Go lie down. You'll feel better once the medication kicks in.
This is a crazy way to start the game, by the way, I feel.
We better get moving.
Good luck, Commander.
Luck won't see
like all this creepiness, all this vague, creepy monstrousness. That doesn't sound sci-fi. It sounds just so rantings of a lunatic. Ah, my good friend Saren. My college roommate, Saren.
Saren? Nihlus. This isn't your mission, Saren. What are you doing here?
The Council thought you could use some help on this one.
Doubt.
I wasn't expecting to find the Geth here.
Not happening, man.
The situation's bad.
Don't worry.
He's so spiky.
I've got it under control.
No. No, turn around. I can't run there fast enough to save him. I'm not Barry Allen. Also, I would cause a flashpoint situation, so why would I do that? Like, duh. You don't want to be having that. Especially if Ezra Miller's involved. Definitely not. Oh. Ashley, what are you doing? Okay, this guy's lost or something. I don't know. His internal GPS is just leading him in circles because he is having some major issues. Okay, let's go get this guy. I want to go try to open that thing up there. This is going to trigger a boatload of dudes. Okay, let's go. Or a cutscene, potentially, because there is a guy here. What is happening? Why are you just standing back there? You suck, man. There we go. There we go. Let's get the F back up there. To this... crate. What a great crate. Where's this little baby? Yeah. I'm fatigued.
Everybody stay calm out there. We're coming out, we're not armed.
Is it safe? Are they gone?
It is not safe because I'm gonna rob you. I'm sorry.
You're okay now. Nobody's gonna hurt
this
you.
This is a Skyrim bandit situation.
Shit. They would have found us for sure. We owe you our lives.
I still can't believe it. When we saw that ship, I thought it was all over.
It showed up right before the attack. Knew it was trouble the second
there
I
is
saw
no
it.
So way the these shit. Three are alive by the events of Mass Effect 3, so...
Tell me everything you remember about the attack.
Yeah.
The three of us were working the crops when that ship showed up. We just saw it and ran. I don't know what happened to the rest of the crew.
They were by the garage, over near the spaceport, right where that ship came down. No way they survived.
You don't know that! We survived! If they made it to the garage, they could have had a fighting chance!
Do you know anything about the Prothean beacon they dug up?
We're just farmers. We heard they found something out there, but it never really mattered to us.
What else can you tell me about the ship?
I was too busy running to get a clear look.
Tell them about the noise.
It was emitting some kind of signal as it descended.
It was probably trying
to. Whatever
it
was, felt like it was tearing.
I have to go.
Hey, Cole. Jeez, Blake, you gotta learn when to shut up.
You have something to tell me, Cole?
Some guys at the spaceport were running a small smuggling ring, nothing major. In exchange for a cut of the profits, we let them store packages in our sheds.
What kind of packages?
I found a pistol. Figured it would come in handy if those things came back.
We're but... risking our lives to save this colony. You sure there's nothing else in here that can help us out?
Yeah, there's one more thing. I was gonna sell it after this was over, but you probably...
Damn, dude, you found so much stuff, for real. I can't believe it.
Who's your contact at the spaceport, Cole? What's his name?
He's not a bad guy. I don't want to get him in trouble. Besides, I'm not a snitch.
Okay, forget about it.
Good luck.
Damn.
Fuck.
I came here to get away from the stress of living on Earth. Yeah.
Commander, it's Nihlus.
I see. I'm just gonna snuffle around here real quick, though. I kind of forgot that I could use assault rifles. About the same. Yish. Should be using your gosh darn pistol. What's your name, Caden? I thought I had more ammo types. Oh, they are there. No, those are combat sensors. That's fine, I guess. Yeah. There you go, my guy. Yeah, I thought I had some more fun ammo types, so this is all good. New save, please. New save. Thank you.
Something's moving over behind those crates.
Blow this guy away, man.
Don't shoot! I'm one of you! I'm human!
Sneaking up on us like that nearly got you killed.
I am sorry. I was hiding from those creatures. My name's Powell.
I saw what happened to that Turian. The other one shot him.
I need to know how Nihilus
the other
died.
One got... Your friends seem to relax.
Yeah, I gotta get to the Citadel. Sorry, guy.
Wait a minute.
You survived?
They must have been inside that... Hard to believe that... And it was making this noise.
We need to find that...
Take the...
I gotta get some warp achievements and stuff, man. Like, I can't be hanging out with you down there. You are in the middle of a fight, though. Oh, you mean... Okay, don't talk in the middle of a fight. I thought you... Okay, well, that was a silly misunderstanding, Ashley. Williams. Oh, whoa, what's my crouch button? I don't remember. Okay, there we go. Ho. Whoops. Oh man, I forgot I don't have to reload. I'm gonna keep throwing my freaking grenades and I know it. I want to for this though. Really? Can somebody lift him or like... trick him into coming out of that. Good. It all worked out then. Just gonna save a tiny bit closer. Don't have to kill those guys again. I'll probably save after most combats just for... I don't trust. Oh, I guess I'm not playing the original Mass Effect. That had a crappy autosave system. It was few and far between. That's all. And I keep thinking that I'm playing that still. It feels like it. This was a cute remake. It was fun. It was cute. I love that synth. Not that synth. I mean, the music. Wow, Saren has the crazy eyes, huh? That's, you walk the other way when you see those. You go to meet your Tinder date, he has those crazy Saren eyes. Bam. Why are your eyes cybernetic? They're new contact lenses, Shepard. It's Shepard, apparently, who's don't on a date with him, I guess. I don't know why.
Hurry. We need to find
not part of my fan fiction or anything. Cover me, guys. Forgot I leveled up. I would really like you to get to lift, you dweeb. Whoa. Good slow-moving fireball. But I used to play a lot of Mario Brothers on the NES. And I know how to dodge slow-moving fireballs on a long, long, flat plane. Trust me, if there was a giant spiked turtle at the end of this, you would be screwed. Oh no, this is way worse actually. If the turtle had a sniper rifle, I would have been screwed. Yeah, of course. Stick your flashlight noodle out. There you go. I didn't think you'd do it. I just told you to do it. Like, as a trick, and it worked. I can't believe it worked. You're so dumb. You shouldn't do what the enemy says. Why would you do that? Embarrassing. One charge remaining. Disarming.
I'm a little busy here.
Doing what? All the charges have been disarmed. You busy slacking off, Ashley? Being a lazy human? This is why the alien races and consoles don't like us. Yoink. Where is he? I see him on the map. I feel like... Oh, are they on the spikes? No. Yep, here they come. Let me get this super secret crate over here. Be so frustrating if I got over here and I could not decrypt it. It's like, yeah, this is locked, fuck you. I don't think there's anything on this side, but now I'm curious. I'm side curious and I need to go over here and check it out. Nothing. Ashley, I wish you'd told me that. I'm so embarrassed now. The Prothean bacon. Oop. I'm really snacky. I'm hungry.
Normandy, the beacon is secure.
This is amazing. Actual working Prothean technology. Unbelievable.
It wasn't doing anything like that when they dug it up.
It was crying when we dug it up. It's weird.
Roger, Normandy. Standing by.
Like it sounded like an infant crying. Left in the woods for the wolves. May, don't touch that, stupid. I gotta be humanity's savior. Ugh. All the glory for Shepard.
Shepard.
Oof. But she touched me, Ashley. Why can't I save her? Oh, okay, that's why. She got a grenade to the face. Oh, wow, Caden, you're all caked up, man. What's happening there? Oh, wow. Woo!
We identified the ship that touched down on Eden Prime, the Normandy, a human alliance vessel.
Yeah, sorry about that.
Of Captain Anderson, they managed to save the colony.
And the beacon.
One of the humans may have used it.
Arg, rar, arg. Ew, look at his little nose snuffling.
Must be eliminated.
Eliminated. She's like, why are you looking at my eyes? My gigantic blue boobies are down here. Like, okay, sorry.
I know.
You're proud. I get it, Benezia.
You had us worried there, Shepard. How are you feeling?
Minor throbbing. Nothing serious. How long was I out?
About 15 hours. Something happened down there with the beacon, I think.
It's my fault. I must have triggered some kind of security field when I approached it. You had to push me out of the way.
You had no way to know what would happen.
Actually, we don't even know if that's what set it off.
Actually, he did. We briefed him before. He did it to put you in danger deliberately. Would you like us to put you out the airlock, Commander? Yes.
The blast knocked you cold. Williams and I had to carry you back here to the ship.
Damn.
I appreciate it.
Physically, you're fine. But I detected some unusual brain activity. Abnormal beta waves. I also noticed an...
You were dreaming of being a beta, Commander.
Signs typically associated with intense dreaming.
I saw... I'm not sure what I saw. Death, destruction... Nothing's really clear.
I better add this to my report. It may... Oh.
Commander Shepard had a bad little dream. Get out of here, you're fine.
Well, all the readings look normal.
Jock was just really mean about it.
Glad to hear it. Shepard, I need to speak with you. In private.
Aye, aye, Captain. I'll be in the mess if you need me.
Jock was like, I'll be here. This is my office.
Sounds like that beacon hit you pretty hard, Commander. Are you sure you're okay?
I don't like soldiers dying under my command.
Jenkins wasn't your fault. You did a good job, Shepard.
Did we leave Gunnery Chief Williams back on Eden Prime?
I figured we could use a soldier like her. She's been reassigned to the Normandy.
Williams is a good soldier. She deserves it.
Lieutenant Elenko agrees with you. That's why I added her to our crew.
Oh, yeah. Thanks, Elenko. I am pissed off about the Geth.
Intel dropped the ball, sir. We had no idea what we were walking into down there. That's why things went to hell.
The Geth haven't been outside the Vale in 2 centuries, Commander. Nobody could have predicted this.
You said you needed to see me in private, Captain?
I won't lie to you, Shepard.
Capitan.
Nihlus is dead. The beacon was destroyed and Geth are invading.
Capitan. Then you do the Hunger Games thing? We've got nothing to hide.
I didn't do anything wrong, Captain. Hopefully the Council can see that.
I'll stand behind you and your report, Shepard. You're a damned hero in my books. That's not why I'm here. It's Saren, that other Turian. Saren's a specter, one of the best. A rogue specter's trouble. But you were there just before the... We need to report. He has the secret. It's not that... We should be getting close.
I'm gonna get a snack.
Head up to the bridge and tell Joker to bring us up here. Dock.
Replenish the metagel, it should do it automatically. This was a lot more like a weird old RPG without a lot of quality of life improvements. What's up, Commander?
Go speak to Joker when you're ready. Tell him to bring the Normandy into dock.
Yes, sir, Arbiter.
I'm glad you're okay, Commander. Part of me feels... Thanks, Commander. And you never get... Thanks, Commander. Thanks, Commander.
You're welcome.
Yes, Commander. But humanity.
Let me just get through all these so I can get my Paragon points and my something else.
Well, most biotics. The crew knows he's seen pretty much anything.
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
Codex entries. That's it. Okay, I've spoken to you and Williams and
Kaden. Commander, I'm glad to see you're okay. Losing Jenkins.
Things were pretty rough down
there. Yeah, you never get used to seeing dead. We're Marines. The Citadel Council's not going to be happy.
Lieutenant Leroy Jenkins will be missed.
Sessions out of the
we gotta go.
Besides my father, word is we're heading. Whatever happens, we'll be.
Whatever happens, happens. If we die, we die.
I'm glad you're okay, Commander. Losing Jenkins was hard enough on the crew.
But losing everyone? Look at all these empty pilot seats.
See that taxpayer money at work.
It's so mysterious down there in the clouds. Not all that matters, Ashley.
Sizes and everything.
See? Why Ashley, that Joker? Joker knows.
Just saying, you need firepower too.
Oh, well, I mean, look, I assume that thing has firepower, honestly. It looks insane.
In any ship in the Alliance fleet.
Good yeah. Thing it's on our side, then.
Citadel Control, this is SSV Normandy, requesting permission to land.
Alliance operator.
Roger, Alliance Tower, Normandy out.
Normandy, this is Alliance Tower. Please proceed to Dock 422.
This is an outrage! The Council would step in if the Geth attacked a Turian colony!
The Turians don't found colonies on the borders of the Terminus systems, Ambassador.
Humanity was well aware of the risks when you went into the Traverse.
What about Saren? You can't just ignore a rogue Spectre. I demand action!
You don't get to make demands of a Council, Ambassador.
Citadel Security is investigating your charges against Saren. We will discuss the CSEC findings at the hearing, not before.
Captain Anderson, I see you brought half your crew with you.
Just the ground team from Eden Prime, in case you had any questions.
I have the mission reports. I assume they're accurate?
They are. Sounds like you convinced the Council to give us an audience.
They were not happy about it. Saren's their top agent. They don't like him being accused of treason.
Saren's a threat to every human colony out there. He needs to be stopped. The Council has to listen to us.
Settle down, Commander. You've already done more than enough to jeopardize your candidacy for the Spectres. The mission on Eden Prime was a chance to prove you could get the job done. Instead, Nihlus ended up dead and the beacon was destroyed.
That's Saren's fault, not hers.
Then we better hope the CSEC investigation turns up evidence to support our accusations. Otherwise, the Council might use this as an excuse to keep you out of the Spectres. Come with me, Captain. I want to go over a few things before the hearing. Shepard, you and the others can meet us at the Citadel Tower, top level. I'll make sure you have clearance to get in.
And that's why I hate politicians.
Earthclan, you are in the wrong place, I think. Your ambassador is next door in the large office.
Chastising remark. Don't be so rude, Din. At least introduce yourself.
I am Din Korlak, Volus Ambassador. Is there something I can do for you, Earthclan?
What is this place?
You are in the embassy for the Volus and the Elcor.
Your ambassador is next door, in his own office.
In this shared space, I aid my fellow Volus, when I'm not being interrupted.
I'd like to know more about...
I'm sure our history and culture would bore you.
Actually, I would like...
Since we're not physically a dead...
Chastised.
You are...
Dismissive.
Really? Yeah.
Hello there, human.
You seem distressed.
Alarmed response. I cannot...
Where can I find this?
She is across the bridge from here. Her offices are easy enough to spot.
Good day, Commander. The human ambassador is up the stairs first.
You know who I am?
Yes, I receive reports on all newly arrived dignitaries and notable people.
What is this place?
This, if you have more questions, please.
What's that?
Oh, Avena. My name is Sephiria. I'm the administrative assistant for
you
the
You seem
embassy.
To be distracted.
The embassies are the hub of all Citadel politics. When you represent trillions of citizens, it tends to get a little busy.
What's your name?
My name is Sephiria. I'm the administrative assistant for the embassies.
I should be going now.
Have a pleasant day.
Welcome to the Presidium. Greetings and welcome to the Presidium. Our records indicate... I apologize if you found my service unsatisfactory. Please submit any complaints in writing to the Citadel Tourist and Visitor...
I can't believe I landed a job here. This place is fantastic.
Human, delighted, welcome. It is good to meet you.
What do you want?
Oh, Commander. Is there something I can do for you?
Relax, Private. This isn't an inspection.
Right, sorry. What can I do for you, Commander?
Yes, it is.
What can you tell me about the Asari consort?
Well, she's an Asari who works here as... That is, she helps people with... things.
You never went to see her, did you, Fredericks?
No, I never did. I couldn't afford it. It costs half a year's credits just to go in and talk to her.
Can you at least tell me where I can find her?
Sure. She's across the bridge from the embassies.
Thanks, kid. Have fun. Try not to get into too much trouble.
I will. Have fun, that is. Commander, good to see you again.
Hello, Commander. Can I get you
What have you got?
Information, mostly.
What's going on around
here? Well,
you...
Across the bridge, you'll find the back... If you need supplies, you can... She's very... Cora's den. So long, Commander. Have a pleasant day.
I don't have time to talk now. I'm very busy.
Yeah, we'll see about that later, sucker. Oh, man, I see where you are.
Shepard, I didn't expect to see you here. Did Ambassador Udina send you?
Have we met before?
No, but I know you well enough. I'm Executor Palin, head of CSEC. It's my job to know when someone like you arrives on the Citadel. Was there something you needed, Commander?
I get the feeling you're not too fond of humans.
No, I just don't trust your kind. Not yet. You humans are eager to take all the power you can get, and you're being given a lot. If the Council wants to make humanity their new favorite pet, that's their business. But I don't have to like it.
What do you know about
the right hand? More like the underhanded side of the council.
What do you know?
More like the underhanded side. More like the underhanded side. Especially when it's left up to each.
Yeah, right.
We do our best to find and punish any. We're, of course, as the seasick represent. Sorry, Commander. I don't make. Goodbye, Mark.
Thank you.
I can't tell the aliens from the animals.
Big place.
Do not disturb the keepers. Welcome to Presidium Tourism Terminal 2. You are standing near the base of the Citadel. Behind, to your left, you may see the keepers are essential to the smooth operation of the Citadel. Thank you for using Avena. Have a pleasant day.
What's this? One of the Earth Clan. Ah, a very famous one, yes? You are the one called Shepard. You were at Torfin, correct? You led the final assault against the enemy base, if memory serves.
How did you know that? Are you a seer?
You've got me at a disadvantage here.
Forgive me, Earth Clan. My name is Barla Vaughn. My job makes it necessary for me to keep informed. I am a financial advisor to many important clients here on the Citadel. When someone as important as yourself arrives on the station, I take notice. Galactic. I also... Even if his true motives were to help his... Then... From the Presidium... But only the most powerful. You never know what you'll find out. Goodbye, Commander.
Sorry, should I have just stood on all your products like that? They don't usually let me do that at the Apple Store.
Ah, human.
Who are you?
This one's...
Please take time to examine the fine goods. This one is able to procure almost any. And we rarely. Please take time. Oh, this one.
Nothing. I've had my office rearranged 5 times now.
5 times? Why? What do they want?
How should I know? It's not like keepers offer.
Welcome. I am. Would you like me to see? But if you wish to leave your name, she'll make. It's our job. My special. Excellent. Most of the time. I suggest you make an appointment and see for yourself. Oh, well, I hope you'll...
Nalina.
Yes, Shaira?
Send the commander...
Huh. It appears the... Just head upstairs.
I guess my squad mates are gonna come watch me hook up over here. It's gonna be weird.
Welcome.
This is my first time. I can't believe I didn't come...
Just warning, guys. I cry after. I get weepy.
That is close enough, Commander. I've heard a great many things about you since your arrival here in our citadel.
What exactly do you do?
That depends on your needs. I offer advice to some, comfort to others. I have a certain problem that could use your expertise.
Maybe I can help.
I have a friend, Septimus. A retired Turian general. I won't discuss the details, but he wanted me to be more than I could be. We had a falling out. Now he spends his days in Korra's den, drinking and spreading lies about me. If you would speak to him as a fellow soldier, I believe he will listen to you and let the matter be.
What happened between you?
I respect his privacy too much to go into the details. If he wishes to tell you what happened, that is his prerogative.
What exactly do you want me to tell him?
Appeal to a sense of honor. Remind him of his position as a general. If you can convince him to stop spreading lies about me, I would be very grateful. Now I must ask you to take your leave. I have many clients waiting to see me. Please, Commander. I ask that you return to me only after you have spoken with Septimus.
You're with the Alliance? My brother.
I have to admit, I'm a little nervous.
That's understandable. Many are a little unsure what to expect their first.
Welcome to Presidium Tourism Terminal 3. Here in the Financial District, a number of businesses offer various goods and services to their exclusive clientele. The statue you see before you was commissioned to honor the Krogan soldiers who gave their lives to protect Citadel space during the Rachni Wars. In the aftermath of the Krogan rebellions, several embassies petitioned to have the statue removed. However, this motion was eventually quashed by the Council.
Tell me more about the Krogan rebellions.
In recognition of their efforts during the Rachni Wars, the Krogan were granted several new colony worlds by the Council. Over the next 400 years, the Krogan species began to expand. Faced with a critical overpopulation crisis, the Krogan started a violent colonization of nearby worlds inhabited by other Council species. The Krogan rebellions had begun. For a full century, the Council and its member species fought to bring the Krogan under control. With the aid of the newly discovered Turian Empire, they were ultimately successful.
Tell me more about the
Krogan. In recognition of their efforts over the next for a full century, I am unfortunately the Krogan then I am sorry, but a value judgment.
That's all for
Thank
now.
You for using Avena. Have a pleasant day.
Saren's hiding something. Give me more time. Stall them.
Stall the Council? Don't be ridiculous. Your investigation is over, Garrus.
Commander Shepard, Garrus Vakarian. I was the officer in charge of the CSEC investigation into Saren.
Sounds like you really want to bring him down.
I don't trust him. Something about him rubs me the wrong way. But he's a specter. Everything he touches is classified. I can't find any hard evidence.
I think the Council's ready for us, Commander.
Good luck, Shepard. Maybe they'll listen to you. You don't want to keep the council waiting.
Don't be ridiculous. The Volus won't be joining the council for years.
I'm not so sure. The humans are making a strong push, and you can bet the vote.
No, I'm... Commander.
The hearing's already started. Come on.
The Geth attack is a matter of some concern, but there is nothing to indicate Saren was involved in any way.
The investigation by Citadel Security turned up no evidence to support your charge of treason.
An eyewitness saw him kill Nihlus in cold blood.
We've read the Eden Prime reports, Ambassador. The testimony of one traumatized dock worker is hardly compelling proof.
I resent these accusations. Nihlus was a fellow Spectre and a friend.
That just let you catch him off guard.
Captain Anderson, you always seem to be involved when humanity makes false charges against me. And this must be your protege, Commander Shepard, the one who let the beacon get destroyed.
The mission to Eden Prime was top secret. The only way you could know about the
beacon... With Nihlus gone, but what can you expect?
Saren just...
Your...
Shepard's
this meeting has no...
What we...
There is still...
Are we...
I agree.
Do you have anything else?
I'm glad...
This meeting is adjourned.
A mistake bringing you into that hearing, Captain. You and Saren have too much history. It made the Council question our motives.
I know Saren. He's working with the Geth for one reason. To exterminate the entire human race. Every colony we have is at risk. Every world we control is in danger. Even Earth isn't safe.
Tell me about this history between you and Saren.
I worked with him on a mission.
I got some Cheetos.
Things went bad. Real bad. We shouldn't talk about this here. But I know what he's like. And he has to be stopped.
What's our next step?
As a Spectre, he's virtually untouchable. We need to find some way to expose him.
What about Garrus, that CSEC investigator? We saw him arguing with the Executor.
That's right. He was asking for more time to finish his report. Seems like he was close to finding something on Saren.
Any idea where we could find him?
I have a contact in CSEC who can help us track Garrus down. His name is Harkin.
Forget it. They suspended Harkin last month, drinking on the job. I won't waste my time with that loser.
You won't have to.
I don't want the Council using your past history with Saren as an excuse to ignore anything we turn up. Shepard will handle this.
You can't just cut Captain Anderson out of this investigation.
The Ambassador's right. I need to step aside.
I need to take care of some business. Captain, meet me in my office later.
Harkin's probably getting drunk at Cora's Den. It's a dingy little club in the lower section of the wards.
Maybe there's another way to find evidence against Saren.
You should talk to Barla Vaughn over in the Financial District. Rumor has it he's an agent for the Shadow Broker.
The Shadow Broker?
An information dealer. Buys and sells secrets to the highest bidder. I've heard Barla Vaughn's one of the top representatives. He might know something about Saren, but his information won't come cheap.
You and Saren have a history. What happened?
About 20 years ago, I was part of a mission in the Skillian Verge. I was working with Saren to find and remove a known terrorist threat. Saren eliminated his target, but a lot of people died along the way, innocent people. And the official records just covered it all up. But I saw how he operates. No conscience, no hesitation. He'd kill 1,000 innocent civilians to end a war without a second thought.
Killing innocents doesn't end wars. It causes them.
I know how the world works, Commander. Sometimes you're forced to make unpleasant decisions. But only if there's no other way. Saren doesn't even look for another option. He's twisted, broken. He likes the violence, the killing. And he knows how to cover his tracks.
Sometimes 1,000 people must die so 1,000,000 can live.
But only if there's no other way. Saren doesn't even look for another option. He's twisted, broken. He likes the violence, the killing. And he knows how to cover his tracks.
Our ambassador doesn't seem to get along with the Council.
He's just frustrated. The Council's always preaching that we need to be part of the galactic community. But for them, it's a one-way street. They want us to expand and settle unstable regions like the Skillian Verge and the Attican Traverse. But when we run into trouble, they don't want to help us out. Everyone knows it's only a matter of time until we get a seat on the Council. The Ambassador just thinks it should happen sooner rather than later. And I agree.
You and Saren have a history. What happened?
About 20 years ago, I was part of a mission in the Skillian Verge. I was working with Saren to find and remove a known terrorist threat. Saren eliminated his target, but a lot of people died along the way, innocent people. And the official records just covered it all up. But I saw how he operates. No conscience, no hesitation. He'd kill 1,000 innocent civilians to end a war without a second thought.
I want to know
they're
more
not
about...
It's not easy preserving peace across an... They see something in you. They tend to operate outside the law, do whatever it... The entire galaxy. But when something does go wrong, there's roughing up suspects in custody. But it looks like his time, if the embassy wasn't protecting him, he would have been fired 15 years. He's not a threat to anyone, not directly. He's got an impressive client list. Good luck, Shepard.
Commander.
That's her.
Those were Saren's men.
Negative contacts, Commander.
I got business here, but not with you.
Commander. What do you want?
What's bothering you, General?
I've seen a lot of horrible things in my days, and there's only one woman in this damn galaxy that helps me forget it.
So if you feel that way, then why spread lies about her?
Because she rejected me. Me, Septimus Araka, General of the Turian Fleet.
I think I can see why you're upset, but spreading these lies won't make it better.
Look, kid, I appreciate what you're trying to do, but don't waste your time.
You need to start acting like...
No, those days are... So you think it's...
I don't think it can hurt.
Maybe you're right, Commander. Shaira...
This is no place for someone of your stature.
All right, I'll go. Say, you're a bright kid. Would you be interested...
What do you want me to do?
There's an Elcor...
Why does he think that?
Because I told him.
What makes you...
Take this data pad. Well, here's to soldiers acting like soldiers. Thanks, Commander. You know, you might make a good general yourself one day.
Hard to imagine a general like that get...
Not now. I'm watching the show.
Back off, Rex. Fist told us to take you down if you showed up.
What are you waiting for?
I'm standing right here. This is Fist's only chance. If he's smart, he'll take it.
He's not coming out, Rex. End of story.
This story is just beginning. Out of my way, humans. I have no quarrel with you.
What was that all about?
Who knows? Let's just try not to get caught in the middle.
The back rooms are private, reserved for Fist.
Who's Fist?
Not real chatty.
Enjoy the club.
Hey there, sweetheart. You looking for some fun? Because I gotta say, that soldier getup looks real good on that body of yours. Why don't you sit your sweet little ass down beside old Harkin? Have a drink. See where this goes.
Maybe later.
Suit yourself, princess. You know, if more Marines looked like you, I might have joined the Alliance instead of seasick.
Harkin, right?
I know where Garrus is. Screwed up his mission so bad they have to ask him. I spent 20 years... Fine, ask Anderson. I bet he tells
hell yeah, fem shep. Bounce, 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 bounce.
Why should I believe a drunk like you?
Fine, ask Anderson. I bet he tells you. He's too stupid and proud to lie right to your face.
Just tell me where Garrus went.
Garrus was sniffing around Dr. Michelle's office. She runs the med clinic on the other side of the wards. Last I heard, he was going back there.
Why are you laying like Jeff Goldblum in Jurassic Park? I feel like you're gonna unbutton that space shirt.
How well do you know Captain Anderson?
Met him a few times. That's probably why he climbed the Alliance.
The captain's a good soldier.
Yeah, he earned his rank.
Great.
You suck, whatever your name is, Harkin. Yeah.
Save your
gonna mess you up.
He'll pay for it
in 18 months.
The executor loves to. Yeah, good. Go.
Let's go find Garbus. Garbus, please.
Why didn't Captain Anderson tell us he used to be a Spectre?
He was ashamed.
It's not true. Harkin's an ass. I bet he's just messing.
Hello there. Welcome to Moreland's famous... Oh, you will be pleased, I think.
I don't have any money. I just wanted to snoop around for a little bit and talk to that boy. No, there was a sketchy duck. It's like a sketchy cow. How do I... Let me find that telephone application. Oh yeah, that duck wants to steal your creds. What is... Oh. Oh good, the window's closed. I was kind of worried it was gonna loop right through there. Like, it's intrigued, it wants to just... leap into a human presence.
Is that real? You're Commander Shepard, the hero of Eden Prime. I am so honored to meet you.
Sure.
Nice to meet you. And you are?
My name is Conrad. Conrad Werner. They say you killed more than 100 Geth on Eden Prime.
It's my internet. If you could hear me, it's my internet. I've been streaming for 2.5 hours, and it's been fine, and all of a sudden it just dropped to really, really low. I don't know why it crapped out.
I spent most of my time trying to stay alive and help the colonists.
Hey, I know you're probably busy.
Shitty,
but,
shitty internet timing. Xfinity sucks, D. TBH.
Anything?
Did I just sign
plan?
His dick?
Here.
Yeah.
Thanks. I really appreciate it. My wife is going to be so impressed. I'll let you get back to work. Oh, but next time you're on Earth, I'd love to buy you a drink. Thanks again.
Next time I'm back on Earth, good luck with that.
Best place on this ward to buy upgrades. Hello, Earth Clan.
What colonies are you talking about?
Oh, my mistake.
Yeah, that duck was a huge creeper. It was trying to sneak food from you.
It doesn't matter. Pharos? Novaria?
It takes food or bills.
You haven't heard of them yet, but it doesn't matter where you hail from.
Show me what you got.
Welcome back, EarthClan. I don't get too many clients from there. As you said,
I'm just filling out my codex, you sucker.
I don't sell this model.
Look, I know it was you. I remember your face.
Really, that's impressive. Usually, you humans can't tell one Turian from another.
This was the place. Now, are you going to give me a refund or not?
Do you have your proof of purchase?
What? No, no, I don't think you ever gave me one.
I'm sorry, then. I can't help you.
But, what do you...
Yeah, all the weird dark synthwave is really cool. Even if the new games hadn't, I guess it changed composers, it got bigger budget and everything. And it had different vibes throughout it, but I do wish they had kept some of the similar synthy music. It feels like some of the only places you could hear it are in your cabin on the Normandy in the latter games. Anyway, how we doing? What's up, M. Wong?
I'm an investigative journalist working here on the Citadel. Could I have a moment of your time?
What do you need?
I've been hunting for evidence of corruption and organized crime on the Citadel, but there are places I can't
go. Oh yeah,
go.
That's me.
I was hoping you might share anything you find during your own investigation. I can make it worth your time.
How do you know that my investigation is going to uncover anything you need?
You wouldn't be investigating if it weren't big. And if it's big, it's something I'd like to hear about.
Big A.
You gotta have access to better sources. Why contact me?
I'm using every source I can find, but I think I've got a better shot with you. I read about this.
I would love to see a video of Volus trying to make it up a small flight of stairs.
They tried to surrender.
Just listen to that bad boy wheeze.
Get their hands dirty. Someone who'll do what needs to be done. That's you.
How do you know I'm investigating anything here on the Citadel?
I'm a good journalist, Commander Shepard. Word gets around.
Sounds like a good cause. If I find any information, it's yours.
Thank you, Commander. You won't regret it.
Yeah, they really shouldn't have let me go on the Citadel with all my crazy guns. Shepard about to post her incel manifesto to the extranet. Oh no.
That your professional opinion, sir?
I don't like that the message board lasted that long. That they're still... We still have the space red pillars.
This isn't a station, it's a city.
There must be millions here. It can't be possible to track everyone coming and going.
Why not?
This makes jump zero.
I mean, there's
like
there's landing places,
it's
landing ports.
It's the largest deep space station the Alliance has.
Jump zero.
I mean, people could obviously get smuggled in, but it's like any relative borders, I guess.
How do they keep all that mass from flying apart?
Mass.
The Council represents more races than I thought. No wonder they're careful with newcomers.
They probably just want to keep everything running.
New jizzers.
It's hard keeping all these cultures working together.
Or maybe they just don't like humans.
Why not? We've got oceans, beautiful women, this emotion.
Beautiful
love.
Women.
According to the old vids, we have everything they
wow.
want.
Wow.
When you put it that way, there's no reason they wouldn't like you. I mean, us. Humans, ma'am.
You don't take much shore leave, do you, LT?
Let's just Paragon out the ass. Okay, well, on my end, the internet is back up and smooth. I'm not dropping frames anymore. I'm in the green.
I'll walk drag.
If it's still really crappy in the buffering or something, then maybe refresh. But I'm back up over here, green-wise. Oh, yeah. I like that old Lavender Town music. Ding, 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 ding. But, like, it's a bop, and you're like, oh no, my Pokemon are dying. Where'd this lead? The janitor closet? Am I gonna... Oh, this is the opposite end of Tali's room. That's gross. I don't like that. I don't like seeing it from that way. Unnatural. View of Nebula. Yoink. I don't see her. Garbus, Garbus, I got you, man. No, come on, Garbus. It's okay. Keep your mouth shut
or... Who are you?
Oh, that guy's got a weird little eye patch. Oh my god, thank goodness. Could you imagine if Garrus blew Dr. Michelle's head off in the first scene we meet him in? Enemy sighted. We good?
All targets down.
Yeah, thanks, Ash. Let me just take some metagel. Wait, how do I use one? There we go. I should have used it first. I didn't realize that thing would be empty, Doctor. Hold on, Garrus. I'll get to you in a second, my guy. Oh, my internet shit out again. Perfect. I love it. I love it. I love streaming for hours and then it decides to crap out then. Perfect. What's up, Garrus?
Gave me a clear shot at that bastard.
What were you thinking? You could have hit the hostage.
There wasn't time to think.
I wanted to hit the hostage.
I didn't mean to. Dr. Michelle, are you hurt?
Oh, no, you're lucky I couldn't Paragon interrupt you there, Garrus. You're so lucky.
I know those men threatened you. But if you tell us who they work for, we can protect you.
They work for Feast. They wanted to shut me up, keep me
they
from
worked
telling
for Feast.
About the Quarian.
Does this have anything to do with the investigation into Saren?
I think it might. Dr. Michelle, tell us what happened.
A few days ago, a Quarian came by my office. She'd been shot, but she wouldn't tell me who did it. I could tell she was scared, probably on the run. She asked me about the Shadow Broker. She wanted to trade information.
Ali on the run.
A safe place to hide.
Where is she now?
I put her
if
in
Asterion fangirls have taught me anything, your first intro to a character can literally be threatening you, and they'll still love them.
And the Shadow Broker is
yeah, I kind of feel like I agree. Garrus would also be fan loved if he accidentally blew Michelle's head off, and you could ream him out. That because then it would be a redemption story. People would be like, oh, he could build on that and be like, oh, I really regret doing that. I fucked up. I killed an innocent person. And then you could help him do the Dr. Salian thing to make up for it somehow. And then I guess you could maybe bang Dr. Mitchell's widower.
Geth. Her information
to kind of,
to do with the
you know...
She must be able to link
honor her
to
memory. So you know that you just know that her husband is still getting some. I mean, that's all.
Time we paid Fist a visit.
This is your show, Shepard.
It's like
but
a fucking charity.
As much as you do, I'm coming with you.
You're a Turian. Why do you want to bring him down?
I couldn't.
Not all Turians are friends, Shepard.
But I knew what was really
that'd be weird.
On. Saren is a traitor to the Council and a disgrace to my people.
Welcome aboard, Garrus.
You know, we aren't the only ones going after Fist. The Shadow Broker hired a Krogan bounty hunter named Rex to take him out.
Yeah, we saw him in the bar.
A Krogan might come in handy.
Last I heard, he was at the CSEC Academy.
What's he doing there?
Fist accused
the C-Section
him of
Academy.
We brought Rex in for a little talk.
Rex is training to be a midwife.
Catch him at the academy before he leaves.
Wow, Garrus, it's cool you sing with an entire face. Awesome. Is she the Sentinel or is Caden the Sentinel? Wait, I don't remember. I don't remember what achievement I even need, to be honest. And I don't really feel like checking. Okay, no, I don't want to exit out of the game and everything. Can I check it on my phone in any simple capacity? Steam application. No, not Steam Link. Why is Link so steamy? I know why. My achievements, there they are. Caden is Sentinel. Okay, let me double check what I need here. Scrolling. Got that Steemo scrolling. Use Singularity 25 times. I wonder if that counts for squad mates, because I don't think I have that or will get that. Damping, AI hacking. Oof, I'm gonna have to reload as other characters and just play like the first like few missions and just spam those later. Use Metagel 50 times in Mass Effect 1. I have not even hit that. Find all primary alien races council. I should have done that already. I just followed the wiki and I talked to everyone I had to, I swear. The Sentinel ally. Complete 5 missions with the Alliance Sentinel squad member. Okay. I didn't know what the achievement was going to fucking call her, though. Like, I know it's weird. I know that she is soldier type, but Sentinel is so weird in this to me for Caden. It just doesn't... I know that it's different in Mass Effect 2 and 3. It feels so different. Then that means that I did the Weird Ashley one. I guess I did all those other ones. Two, I swore I got her. I guess not. Fuck it. Who cares? You guys can come with me, because now Caden's been... sucked into his role. Ashley's a good soldier. Just crazy. Can't tell the aliens from the animals kind of person. But the soldier part is fine. I literally just talked to Garrus or something and got a Codex entry. That was cool.
Hey, I know you. You're Shepard, right? Torfin was a case study during my training. I can't believe you took out the whole base. Amazing.
Yeah, the good guys too.
I'm sorry, I just never thought I'd meet someone like you in person. My name's Lang, Officer Eddie Lang, Citadel Security. It's an honor to meet you, Commander. What are you doing down here in the wards? Anything I can help you with?
Why'd you join Citadel Security?
I don't know. Seemed like the right thing to do, you know? It's kind of what... You get to meet all kinds of... Like that new club they just... But if they were so bad... Drinking on the job... Right. You're probably real busy. Well, see you around, Commander.
Make that a stream sound effect. I don't know. I was talking so much crazy shit on the way down. Anything you want? The Mass Effect level up noise? Is what we're talking about? I should do all the level of noises. I don't know how to do more than 10, but I just use one site, and I don't know if I can mix and match sites.
In light of a recent attack on Eden Prime, many colonial investors are pulling their support for future projects. Proponents of expanded human colonization insist that Eden Prime was an isolated case. Nevertheless, colonist enrollment has dropped sharply.
I'm not going to skip
this. Many colonial proposals are on hold until backers have some reassurance that human colonies will be adequately protected.
No, I can't do that. That's too hot. That was risky just doing it once on the stream.
Witnesses saw you making threats in Fist's bar. Stay away from him.
I don't take orders from you.
This is your only warning, Rex.
You should warn Fist. I will kill him.
You want me to arrest you?
I want you to try.
No, really, try. I have that parasite in my brain that makes me make reckless decisions. Like those mice that attack cats. Yeah, Soul Survivor is the one that I normally have done. And I did another really weird, pathetic one, like Space Orphan or something. So this time I finally picked this one, which I don't remember. This is War Hero? This is Ruthless, maybe? This is Ruthless? I have zero Ruths. And I don't know. That's cool. Soul Survivor. I wish there was a little more of it. Even if it didn't affect the story or like decisions, I wish more people, I know that it's traumatic, but would reference it. That everyone should get like two checks for each background throughout the game. Baldur's Gate did it very fun. These games are old.
My name's Shepard. I'm going after Fist. Thought you might want to come along.
Shepard. Commander Shepard. I've heard a lot about you.
No, you haven't.
We're both warriors, Shepard. Out of respect, I'll give you fair warning. I'm going to kill Fist.
Fist knows you're coming. We'll have a better chance if we all work together.
My people have a saying, seek the enemy of your enemy, and you will find a friend.
Glad to have you on the team, Rex.
Let's go.
Yeah, thank the Reapers for seeding the galaxy like that. A lot of the common idioms have just made it everywhere. Kroger comes up to Shepard, he's like, two piejacks in the bush is worth one in the hand, am I right?
Let me get this.
Like, it's like, yeah, Rex, I get it, piejacks.
Straight. Your business partner, Shorban, he's threatened you?
Well, no, not exactly. But he wants to meet with me. I think he's going to kill me.
And why do you think that?
I can't really get into the details. But Shorban will kill me if I leave here unprotected.
I can't help you. Not unless you give me something more to go on.
I can't. I'm sorry.
Then I've got other work to do.
But
nothing. Don't bother me unless you're willing to give me details.
We Krogan have a tradition of celebrating when our offspring are still alive after a year on our planet. After our planet rotates the star in our system. One full rotation. I do need some Paragon points. Yeah, go play some Sims. Sorry for just standing around. Thank you. Thank you for chilling. Go play some Sims 3 or 4. Or that secret copy of Sims 5. I wish I knew what this big, empty, weird room was. I mean, it just looks like a holograph combat arena or some junk, but who knows? There's no way in or out from up here. It's just weird. I'm so bummed. I really should have taken the track. What are those things? The bugs? Insectoids? I'm gonna see if my wife's awake.
Don't play dumb.
So far I've had I'd like to do it. So long. Oh, it's you again.
Tell me again what.
So far I've had mixed results. I'd like to do it more open. I don't even know who you are. You'll need I'll even send a few credits your way for each unique scan. So long.
I don't remember how to get to where I was. Oh, it's in C-Sec, I think.
Thank you.
All right. That's more than a BRB screen. That is a exiting the game screen. It was a deception, and I'm sorry, but have a good night.